Good evening. The president took matters into his own hands today, moving to allow non-citizen students and graduates under 30 to avoid deportation. It's a version of the DREAM Act, which stalled in Congress last year, but has become, for now, the leading immigration issue.
The bill hasn't really changed. The need hasn't changed. It's still the right thing to do. The only thing that has changed, apparently, was the politics. It makes no sense to expel talented young people who, for all intents and purposes, are Americans.
So how far did the president's actions go today, and how far didn't they, Pierre?
Well, Gwen, we're talking about roughly 800,000 people age 16 to 30. And what this allows them to do is to apply for work permits and stay here 2 years. And if they don't get into any kind of trouble, they can be recertified. And again, they're looking at students, people who have served in the military, again, people who have been brought here by their parents. And I think what was very interesting about this is, even though they talked about children, as you can see by the age 16 to 30, we're talking about a lot of young adults who will be allowed to stay in the country.
Now, when they're also not talking about a pathway to citizenship, but I wonder if that's a distinction without a difference, if you're allowed to stay and then be certified and...
Well, look, there's no way you can describe this but a sweeping act that the administration did today. Again, you're talking about nearly a million people who, like you just said, for all intents and purposes, are here unless they make some grave mistake and break the law.
In fact, the president said, for all intents and purposes, they're Americans just without the paperwork.
Exactly.
So, but didn't the president say at some point about a year ago that he did not have the power to do this? What changed?
It's slightly nuanced. He did an interview with Univision, and he said that he didn't have the executive authority, that he couldn't do it by a presidential order to basically keep people from being deported. Well, we interviewed the Secretary of Homeland Security today, and she said, I'm using prosecutorial discretion. In other words, I'm not going to do this because I have other priorities. And the priorities have been deporting criminals, people that they consider to be possibly having ties to terrorists. And in fact, last year they set a record for deportations of nearly 400,000 people.
So this was an executive action, but not an executive order.
Exactly.
Okay. Pierre, what's with the timing of this? I mean, it seemed to come out of nowhere on a Friday afternoon. What was the reason
for doing it now? I like to think I cover the Homeland Security Department pretty closely, and I can tell you, no clue this was coming.
Yeah.
The Republicans obviously today said this is pure, unadulterated politics. The administration said this is just an evolution of what they've been doing. Look, for all practical purposes, the administration does not deport children. They're not out hunting for children to deport them. What they have been focused on, again, are criminals, people who have been ordered to be deported, who stayed in the country for whatever reason. And they simply didn't have the manpower. And you've even heard Republicans say, we can't deport 12 million people en masse. That's not going to happen. But by putting this on paper and saying, you can stay, and say you can have a work permit, that codifies it in a very meaningful way to a lot of people. Mm-hmm.